In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Highlevel Workflows to create automated services that you can sell and deliver to small businesses at very attractive price points, but that are very high margin for you, create recurring revenue, and are easy to set up and deliver. And if you're not familiar with Highlevel, Highlevel is an absolutely game-changing tool that I recommend to everybody in this industry to help them create and deliver those very high margin automated services. If you'd like to learn more about why I recommend it so much, I've got a URL here down below. It's servicesthatscale.com/Highlevel. On that page, I'll give you a thorough breakdown of why I think that Highlevel is the must-have tool for this industry. And as well, you can get a 14-day free trial to give it a shot yourself from that page. If you're not familiar with workflows, you'll see them here in just one moment, but workflows are a visual way of mapping out automation sequences within the Highlevel platform. And there's almost no end to the capabilities of these workflows. You can trigger them as in activate them based on all kinds of different conditions. You can make them fire based on somebody's birthday or anniversary. You can send emails and SMSs. You can assign tasks to members of your team. You can pull people out of these workflows based on certain conditions, like have they completed a step or not completed a step. You can send them reminder sequences based on those certain conditions. And you can send somebody back through the workflow when they're done if they haven't accomplished what you want them to accomplish. So the ability that you have to create really unique automated services and processes within workflows is really up to your imagination. So it's really cool. Highlevel has essentially turned you into a programmer without you having to be a programmer. I don't know about you, but I'm not a real technical guy. And so I can't program, but with Highlevel, I really can program what I want to happen just by using this visual workflow builder. Okay, in this particular case, let's say that we're selling to and servicing restaurants. Now with restaurants, like most small businesses, you can actually put together a pretty darn predictable marketing calendar based on certain milestone dates of the year, right? Around January, you've got New Year's, February, you got Valentine's Day, March, you've got March Madness or St. Patrick's Day, April, you've got Easter, May, Mother's Day, and on and on and on. Each of these holidays or special events are a great opportunity to do some promotion around. And the same is true for just about any small business out there. And that's why what I'm going to show you here today is one of my favorite automation structures using these workflows that you can create that's going to just run automated services for your customers month after month and generate revenue and profits for you. Okay, so what's pretty cool here is I actually just found really quickly, I just did a search, and you can get all of these campaign assets for free. So if you're selling to restaurants, this is gonna be a gold mine for you, this video. DoorDash is actually providing, you can see here, a 2021 restaurant marketing calendar and toolkit that's full of all kinds of campaign templates, social media templates, 19 holiday promotion tips to drive sales. So you can download this kit and really get this whole thing laid out for you and have a bunch of cool campaign assets so that you're not starting from scratch. Once you do that, we're going to use the workflows to build automated promotions around these holidays and events, okay? So let's go into Highlevel here real quick, and you can see what I've designed for you is a Valentine's Day promo workflow template, okay? So the restaurant that you're working with is going to want to do a promotion around Valentine's Day. So in this workflow, you can see here the foundation of this workflow is actually this set event start time Valentine's Day. Okay, so what I've told the system is that Valentine's Day is on February 14th. And I've said specifically, let's trigger around 10 a.m. on Valentine's Day. So the system now knows that the anchor date of this workflow is February 14th. So if I go back up here to the top of this workflow, you can see here that I've got a wait step. This wait step is actually tied to that event start time. You can see right here, wait for the event appointment time. And then it says before 14 days. So this is going to trigger 14 days before Valentine's Day And then what I've got it set to do is set an email. And that email would be an email to the restaurant's customers saying, hey, Valentine's Day is coming up. Make your Valentine's Day reservations now before they're all gone. Okay, so I just put in some simple text here, but you can put a full, beautiful HTML email template in here with images and a button that they can press to go and make reservations. So you can do all of that inside of Highlevel, just like you could with any full email marketing system. So it's gonna send an email, and then it's also going to send an SMS that says, hey, don't forget to make your Valentine's Day reservation. Of course, that will only fire if we have the customer's phone number. Now, I have another wait step. This wait step says, wait 7 days before Valentine's Day. At 7 days before Valentine's Day, I've got another round of emails and another round of SMS, again, encouraging people to make their reservations. Now, let's say that they don't make any reservations, but we still want to give opportunities to promote around Valentine's Day and get people to come in. So I've got an email also going out on Valentine's Day that says, hey, happy Valentine's Day. We love our customers. Show this message to your server anytime in the month of February and get 25% off of your bill, whatever promotion you want to put in place there. We're now hitting everybody with a promotion to try and get them into the restaurant again in the month of February. Okay, so you can see here, this is a structure that a restaurant should be running every single February around Valentine's Day. And of course, you can, you know, tune this up however you like it, get as creative as you'd like, and depending on the particular kind of restaurant that you're working with, design different campaign templates. All right, so next you can see here at the bottom though, it says add to St. Patrick's Day workflow. Well, March is coming up and we wanna do a promotion around St. Patrick's Day. So this workflow, once somebody has made its way all the way through here, is going to automatically add these people now to the St. Patrick's Day workflow. Now, you may be thinking, well, Mike, what if they actually made a reservation for Valentine's Day? Do we still continue sending them these promotional emails? And the answer is no. So if they actually make a reservation for Valentine's Day, we have a Valentine's Day reservation confirmation and reminder workflow. So let's just say that we set up a form for creating reservations, that we created that form in Highlevel. It's one of the things you can do in Highlevel. And the customer was taken from that original promotion to fill out a reservation request form. So you can see here, reservation form completed. So if they filled out the form, then they are now in this workflow. And the first thing that we're doing is we're removing them from the Valentine's Day promo workflow. So they're not going to continue to get those messages, okay? Now, we are going to send them an email. In this particular case, let's say that we can't automate everything around confirming their reservation date. We actually could, but this is just a simple version of this. So we are actually going to, you know, confirm with them manually. So it says your Valentine's Day reservation has been received. Our host will review it and confirm with you that it's all set within 24 hours. And then just as a demonstration, again, in Highlevel, what we could then do then is add a task to a person on our team that says contact name has requested a reservation for appointment start time. Please confirm it. If not available, please contact them immediately and find another time. Okay, so we're giving the restaurant then the ability to have somebody on their team confirm that appointment. And there is a 24-hour wait step here to give them the time to do that. Now, after that wait step, assuming that the time was okay and they don't need to change anything, then 48 hours before the appointment, there will be a series of messages going out confirming their appointment, a reminder email and SMS, and then again, 24 hours before the reservation, and then 1 hour before the reservation. So you can see here, we've got a reminder sequence to let people sign up for their reservation and then get this reminder sequence. And this is pulling them out of the St. Patrick's Day promotion. Okay. Now, since we pulled them out of the St. Patrick's, or excuse me, out of the Valentine's Day promotion, we want to make sure and add them to the St. Patrick's Day promotion as a final step here. So just to show you in real time here, we're going to say add to workflow right here. And then we're going to select the St. Patrick's Day promotion. Okay, so the St. Patrick's Day workflow template right here, we're gonna save this action. Now, anybody who comes through here and gets reminded of their appointment, or excuse me, their reservation, then afterwards they're going to be added to the St. Patrick's Day workflow. We're gonna save that. And now let's go check out what we're doing in St. Patrick's Day. Okay, St. Patrick's Day, the anchor event, of course, in this case, is St. Patrick's Day, which is March 17th every year. Now, some years, maybe St. Patrick's Day falls on a day of the week that the business you're working with isn't going to have a party on that date. And so you could actually change this to the Friday or Saturday or something like that, that they're going to have a party. But let's just say they're celebrating on St. Patrick's Day. Again, you've got this wait step 14 days before St. Patrick's Day. Got an email, SMS. In this case, it's inviting them to a party. Again, wait. And then 7 days before, reminding them, email and SMS, it's a party. And then it's actually St. Patrick's Day and we have the party. Okay, I think you can see the idea and see the power of this. At the end of the St. Patrick's Day workflow, we could add them to an Easter workflow and then to a Mother's Day, whatever it is. Now, the really cool thing is that with Highlevel, you create these templates once and you save them as what are called snapshots. And now, when you sell to a new restaurant customer, you can sell this service and you can take this snapshot, all of these workflow templates, and just drop them into an account for this new customer, do some minor updates in the values associated with these campaigns. So, you know, what's the specific offer that they want to have, replacing some images potentially, or putting in the name and logo of the restaurant that you're working with, of course. Those things are all very, very easily done inside of Highlevel using what are called custom values. I don't need to get into that detail too much, but what custom values allow you to do is just go to one central location in the account of your customer and make the updates to those custom values there in one place, and it will update all of the fields that you need updated in all of these workflows and all of these campaigns automatically. So in other words, what I'm saying is it will only take you an hour or so to set up a new customer with a whole yearly series of promotions based on the snapshot of these workflow templates that you created and loaded into their account. You activate all these workflows, and now every single month, automatically, these restaurants are going to be sending out the promotions that are going to be driving new business back into their restaurant, repeat customers back into their restaurant, and it's going to make you look like a hero because they're now doing more marketing, more consistent marketing, more professional marketing than they've ever done before. And they're doing it at a price point. You could sell something like this for $397 a month, $497 a month, something like that. Very, very affordable. And yet it really requires almost no effort on your part and would be almost 100% margin to you. So these workflows are an incredible service opportunity for working with small businesses. With small businesses, you have to deliver services that are automated because they have to be at relatively low price points for small businesses to sign up and stick because they just don't have those huge budgets. But again, they've got to be automated so that you can get the margins that you need to be successful. And that's what Highlevel and these workflow templates allow you to do. Now, what I've shown you here is just one specific example of a model that you can create with these workflows. But again, these workflows are so customizable. It really is up to your creativity and your imagination. You can create all kinds of automated recurring services using these workflows and other capabilities inside of Highlevel. As I said earlier, if you'd like to see a complete review of why I recommend Highlevel and all of the amazing things that it does for agencies that are servicing the small business community, please go to servicesthatscale.com/Highlevel and I'll explain exactly why. And again, you can get a 14-day trial to get started there. In addition, I have a free course that shows you how I built two different service businesses selling to the small business community to multiple 7 figures in revenue, Inc. 5000, fastest growing companies 3 years in a row, and was able to exit one of those businesses very successfully because of the predictable recurring revenue that I had created. And of course, my team and I had created. So If you would like that course again for free, I share with you the most important strategies that we use to build those businesses. There's a URL right down here, or it's servicesthatscale.com/grow faster. All right, thank you so much for tuning in. If you found this video helpful, please like it and share it with somebody else that you think would get some value from it. Please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below here. I'd love to hear from you, and I will respond to every single one of them personally. Okay, thank you so much for tuning in, and we'll see you on a future video.